So today's video adapts a direct seed sowing method to actually help prevent and to control slug populations, and it doesn't cost a penny. If you've watched this channel before, you've probably seen me using the plank method. I've been sowing leeks in this bed to help with germination of direct sown seeds, because what you do by putting the plank over where you've sown the seeds is that it stops moisture from evaporating and it helps ensure consistent germination. And this is a technique that I first learned from James Prigioni's channel. But every time I include or mention this method in one of my videos, I will always get a comment where someone says that you're creating a perfect slug habitat and they're going to eat all of your seedlings. After getting quite a few of these comments, I suddenly realized that, hang on a minute, there's actually an opportunity here that we can capitalize on to help control and deal with slug issues. Sadly, I'm going to have to mention the really well-known permaculture cliche of the problem is a solution. But this, using a plank, is a perfect example of this. Let's run through an example. I've got some spinach here that I'm gonna plant directly into this row. I've sown the row. Next up is just to gently cover the compost back over. After I've covered a row back over with compost, I then like to fairly firmly just press it down to make it all nice and secure, help take out some of that air as well, can protect the seedlings against the frost a bit. So once that is done, it's then, if it's doing the method of the plank method, is placing the plank over the top. But this is where the actual turning the problem into a solution comes in, because the worry, which I totally understand, is that when you put the plank over the top and then you kind of keep an eye on it, and then after a few days, you keep looking underneath and then you remove it once you first see seedlings. The worry is that there's going to be slugs hiding underneath the plank that will then eat the seedlings as they start coming through. But for me, how I actually see it is that you can use a plank to its advantage by actually purposefully, as well as not only reducing moisture from evaporating from the soil to help with germination, but also to double up as a slug trap. So before the seedlings germinate, you're actually using a plank to capture as many slugs as possible from the surrounding area, so that when the seedlings do come through, chances are there's gonna be less slugs to worry about. I'm just watering the tiny carrot seedlings that have just come through using the plank method. And the idea is that literally starting the next day, you want to start checking underneath the plank, because after you've watered and you've put the plank on top, that's a perfect, nice, moist environment, which is a perfect place to find slugs. So the morning after sowing, gently turn over the plank, pick off any slugs that are there and place it back. And you repeat that every single day, and it's a great way to actually get a lot of slugs. Up to this point in the video, I've just been talking about direct sowing. However, what about using this method if you're transplanting? Well, you follow the exact same principle, but instead of putting the plank down just after you've transplanted your seedlings, what you want to do is, once you've identified a place where you are going to be transplanting seedlings, especially those like salads that are susceptible to slugs, is a few days before, put down the plank in the area you want it, check every day up until transplant, and then that is another great way just to help remove some of the slugs from the area. The other thing that you can also do with planks is, if you actually spot slug damage in a certain area, you can put a bunch of planks down on your beds and your paths nearby, come back the next day, because if you think about it, when the slugs come out at night and munch on something, they then need a place or a home to return to. So by creating a lot of homes and habitats that are slug friendly and inviting, it's a really easy way to actually navigate potential onslaught. Imagine that that patch of spinach was having some slug damage. Well, what you do is, late afternoon, go around with the watering can and water some areas nearby and around, and then place planks directly on top of these areas, because slugs don't want to hide in dry environments. They want that moisture. And then come back the following morning and chances are you will have caught the majority of the culprits. If you don't have access to planks or pieces of wood, you can use so many other kinds of materials. Three ones that work really well is cardboard, pieces of rubber, and also large stones. This method is so effective and it doesn't have to cost you anything to deal with issues in your garden. And another example of this is if you're struggling from things like aphids, black fly, flea beetles, cabbage white butterflies, this video here will show you the permaculture approach, which is 100% natural and also doesn't have to cost you anything to dealing with pests in your vegetable garden.